Here you can see I have already downloaded MySQL installer. Let's double click it and it brings up welcome screen. Now we will follow a standard MySQL installation. Click on install MySQL products, read and agree to license terms, click on next and it will ask you if you want to check for latest updates. As I have just downloaded my package, there won't be any update, even though it does not harm to check it one more time. Let's click on execute. It will connect to the internet and fetch product update information. Over here, it gives us various options for setup types. Developer options. It installs all products needed for MySQL development purpose. This is the one which we will be selecting. However, it's worth noting there are other options like server only, client only, a full installation and custom installation. Two more things to note before we click on next. First is installation path and second is data path. Installation path is where MySQL will install MySQL and data path is where MySQL will store data files. Click on next. On the prerequisite screen, it will give us list of all the prerequisites. In my case, all the prerequisites are met, hence we are seeing all green check marks. Let's click on next. Now we'll be installing MySQL and all the related product. I would like you to pay close attention to the time it takes to install MySQL Server. The reason is that after I click on execute, you will notice that installing MySQL Server and all related product is very fast and efficient process. Let's click on execute. And we are done. You can see in very few seconds, we installed MySQL Server and all related products. Isn't it easy and efficient? Let's click on next. Here it will ask us to do configuration. After installation, configuration is very important task. However, MySQL configuration is very simple to do. Click on next. Here you have to select your server configuration type. We have development machine, so we'll leave the development machine as a default option. Alternatively, you can also select server machine or dedicated machine as well. In a server machine, you'll have other application also running with MySQL installation. However, in case of the dedicated machine, only MySQL product will be running on this machine. My machine is development machine. Hence, click development machine and click on next. Here, you can enable or disable TCP/IP networking. Let's not change any setting over here and click on next. MySQL Server configuration will ask us to enter root password. And you can see password strength is medium. Let me create another admin user over here. I'll give name Pinal Dave. I'll let the role be DB admin. I'll provide complex password. Click OK. And now we are ready to go to next screen. Click on next. On this screen, MySQL will allow us to configure Windows service details. Here we will change the Windows service name so we can easily identify our MySQL installation. We'll give it a name as SQL Authority. Now click on next. Here you can see, now server configuration is complete. We can click next one more time and samples and example will be configured. Click on next. And now, along with MySQL Server, samples and example are ready to go. Click on next. On a very last screen, it will ask us if you want to start MySQL Workbench after setup, yes or no. I'll leave this one on because that's the next thing which we are going to discuss. Click finish. And immediately you can see MySQL Workbench is open.